Come to exercise 3.3, question number 1. Solve the following pair of linear equations by substitution method. Substitution method already we have discussed. Still then I will do here. X plus y is equal to 14. X minus y is equal to 4. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So from first equation, x plus y is equal to 14. That means y is equal to 14 minus x. This is equation 3. Now substitute, write down here like this. Substitute value of y in equation 2. What will get? X minus y means 14 minus x is equal to 4. X minus 14 plus x is equal to 4, or 2x is equal to 18. Bring this 14 to this side, or x is equal to 9. So what is the value of y? Y is equal to 14 minus x means 14 minus 9 is equal to 5. So y is equal to 5, x is equal to 9. It's okay? So x comma y is equal to 9 comma 5. It's okay? Second bit, s minus t is equal to 3, s by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. Same manner question, you can do on your own. Third bit, 3x minus y is equal to 9. Second, 9x minus 3y is equal to 9. So here a1 by a2 is 1 by 3, b1 by b2 is 1 by 3. So you are not able to solve this by substitution method. Okay? Or any method, you are not able to solve this. Fourth bit, 0.2x plus 0.3y is equal to 1.3, 0.4x plus 0.5y is equal to 2.3. So, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So, replace anyone. Let's say 0.2x plus 0.3y is equal to 1.3. It means 0.3y is equal to 1.3 minus 0.2x, or y is equal to 1.3 minus 0.2x by 0.3. Substitute this equation 3. Substitute this value in equation 4. 0.4x plus 0.5y means 1.3 minus 0.2x by 0.3. So is equal to how much? 2.3. So now multiply this, then take LCM 0.3, it will be okay. Like this, you solve this. Fifth bit, 0.2x plus 0.3y is equal to 0, 0.3x minus 0.8y is equal to 0. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Substitution method means first 0.3y is equal to, bring this to this side, 0.2x. Okay? Now substitute the, okay, y is equal to minus 0.2x by 0.3, means 2 by 3x. It's okay? Now substitute this value of y in equation number 2, 0.3x minus 0.8 into y means 2 by 3. I am removing these decimals, okay? 2 by 3x is equal to 0. So 0.3x, that means take x as common, 0.3 minus 8 into 2.6 by 3 is equal to 0, means x is equal to 0. If you substitute the value of x here, then you will get y is equal to 0. It's okay? Solve 2x plus 3y is equal to 11. 2x minus 4y is equal to minus 24. Hence, find the value of y is equal to mx plus c. Find the value of m. This is question number 2. So, these two equations you can solve this easily. Okay, by substitution method or elimination method, subtract means it will cut. You can find the value of y. Simply substitute the value, then find the value of x and substitute here. In place of x and y, you will get the value of m. It's okay? Question number 3, these are the word sums. So first you have to thorough by the elimination method what I have discussed previously. Okay? Here I will tell you the equation, what are the equations, how to frame the equation. After that, you will solve it on your own. Question number 3, the difference between two numbers is 26, one number is 3 times the other. Difference between two numbers is 26, let one number is x, other number is y. So difference means x minus y is equal to 26. One number is 3 times the other. Let's say x is equal to 3y. This is equation 1. Here x minus 3y is equal to 0. This is equation 2. Now you can solve these two equations by elimination method. X minus y is equal to 26. X minus 3y is equal to 0. Subtract. This is 2y is equal to 26 or y is equal to 13. So substitute 13 here, you will get x equal to 39. It's okay? Question number 3, second bit. The larger of two supplementary angles exceed the smaller by 18 degree. Larger of two supplementary angles means one angle is x, other is y. So two supplementary means x plus y is equal to 180 degree. This is equation 1. The larger of two supplementary angles exceeds the smaller by 18. Means x minus y is equal to 18. Equation 2. Now you solve these two. Okay. Third bit. The coach of a cricket team buys 7 bat and 6 ball for rupees 3800. Similarly, let the cost of 1 bat is x. Cost of 1 ball is y. So 7x plus 6y is equal to 3800. Later she buy 3 bats and 5 balls, 3x plus 5y is equal to 1750. Okay? The taxi fare in a city consists of fixed charge together with the charge for the distance covered. For distance of 10 km the charge was 105. For a journey of 15 km the charge paid is 155. What are the fixed charge and what is the charge per kilometer? Okay? Fourth bit, let fixed charge be x, rate per kilometer be y, or rate is y per kilometer. Now, traveling 10 kilometers, the charge was 105, that means x plus 10y is equal to 105. Fixed charge is x, per kilometer charge is y. So, fixed charge plus 10y, per kilometer is y, 10 kilometer is 10y, is equal to 105. And for traveling 15 kilometer, the charge is 155. Traveling 15 kilometer means x plus 15y is equal to 155. Same manner, by elimination method, xx will cut, you can find easily y value. Then after that, substitute, find x. Fifth bit, a fraction becomes 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. Let numerator be x, denominator be y. So fraction is x by y. Okay? Now, a fraction becomes 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. So x plus 2 by y plus 2. 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. It is 9 by 11. And both the numerator and denominator become 5 by 6 if 3 is added. That means x plus 3 by y plus 3 is equal to 5 by 6. It's okay. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. If you cross multiply this 11x plus 22 is equal to 9y plus 18, bring all these numbers at this side. So make one equation, here also make another equation by cross multiplying. Now solve both. It's okay? Question number 36b. 5 years hence the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. So Jacob, your son. Let Jacob's age, present age is X, son present age is Y. 5 years hence the age of Jacob will be 3 times the age of his son. 5 years hence means X plus 5 is equals to 3 times the age of the son. This is equation 1. 5 years ago Jacob's age will be 7 times that of his son. 5 years ago means x minus 5 is 7 times y minus 5. This is equation 2. So you can easily solve this. Okay? 3.4. Solve the following pair of linear equations by the elimination method and substitution method. Elimination and the substitution method. That means equating coefficient. Okay? So these are very easy. Just look here. Question number 1. First bit. X plus y is equal to 5, 2x minus 3y is equal to 4. Students are advised that it is easy to know about the elimination method. Just see the previous videos. In elimination method, I have done number of questions. Easy to hard one. Okay? Here these are the easy one. Just look here. This is the equation 1, this is equation 2. So x plus y 5, 2x minus 3y is equal to 4. Your coefficient is 1. So simply multiply this by 2. So it will be 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. This is 2x minus 3y is equal to 4. Subtract this. 2y plus 3y means 5y is equal to 10 minus 4 is 6. So y is equal to 6 by 5. What is the value of x? This is the equation 1. X plus y is equal to 5, so x plus y means 6 by 5 is equal to 5, so x is equal to 5 minus 6 by 5, which is equal to 5 LCM, 25 minus 6 means 19 by 5, x, hence x comma y is equal to 19 by 5 comma 6 by 5, it's okay? Similarly, second bit, 3x plus 4y is equal to 10, 2x minus 2y is equal to 2. 3x plus 4y is equal to 10, second bit, 2x minus 2y is equal to 2. Simply multiply this by 2, it will be 6. Multiply this by 3, it will be 6. Then eliminate x, find the value of y, okay? Third bit also same, fourth bit also same, you can do it easily. Then come to question number 2. This is the word sum. If we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, a fraction reduced to 1. Same manner you write, let numerator be x, denominator be y. So fraction is x by y. If we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, that means x plus 1 by y minus 1. A fraction reduced to 1. Okay? Now it becomes 1 by 2 if we only add 1 to the denominator. This is equation 1. The fraction becomes 1 by 2. If we only add 1 to the denominator, that means x by y plus 1 is equal to 1 by 2. This is equation number 2. Now, cross multiply this, make equation, cross multiply this, make equation and solve it easily. Okay. Number 2, second bit. 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. Nuri, Sonu. Let Nuri age is x. Let Sonu age is y. 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. 5 years ago means x minus 5 is equal to thrice y minus 5. It's okay? This is equation 1. Not exactly this is equation 1. X minus 5 is equal to 3y minus 15. Bring the variable to one side, bring the number other side. Now it is equation 1. Okay? 10 years later, Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. That means 10 years later means x plus 10 is equal to twice y plus 10. Frame another second equation here and solve it. It's okay? Third bit, the sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 9. So in previous class, previous video, I have told you that in case of a two-digit number, first you have to write all the things. Let unit digit be x, tenth digit be y. You just follow that. It will be better for you. That means you can clearly understand the question and you can easily solve. Okay? At that point, I also discussed 3 to 4 questions. So just see that video. Let unit digit be x, 10 digit be y. So what is the number here? 10th digit is y means 10y plus x. What is the reverse number? Reverse number means when you interchange the digit, what will the number? That is 10x plus y. What is the sum of the digit? X plus y. Okay? Now make the equation. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 9. That means x plus y is equal to 9. Equation 1. Also 9 times of this number means 9 into 10y plus x. 9 times this number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digit. Twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digit means 10x plus y. So make another equation from here. Solve this, you will get the answer. It's okay. Fourth bit, Minna went to a bank, withdrew rupees 2000. She asked the cashier to give her rupees 50 note, rupees 100 note only. Minna got 25 note in all. How many notes of rupees 50 and rupees 100? Simple thing, just listen to me. If you have 5 number of 10 rupee note, that means the value is rupees 50. If you have 5 number of rupees 100 note, the value is 5 into 100, that is 500. If you have x number of rupees 100 note, so what is the value? 100x. You understand this line? Similarly, I will do the here. I will do the equation here. Minna went to a bank, withdraw rupees 2000. It's okay. She asked the cashier to give him rupees 50 note and rupees 100 note. Minna got 25 note in all. Let rupees 50 note be x. Rupees 100 note be y. Now, you know the number of notes is how much? 25. It's okay, this is equation 1. And in total he got how many rupees? 2000. That means rupees 50 note x times x number of means 50x plus 100 note y numbers means 100y is equal to rupees 2000. This is equation 2. Now you can solve this easily. It's okay? You take 50 as common or divide 50, 50, 50. So you reduce the equation, then solve it easily. Fifth bit. A lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days. This question I have already discussed. A lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days and additional charge for each day thereafter. Sarita paid rupees 27 for keeping 7 days. First 3 days charge is, let's say, x, rupees x. Each additional day for each day is rupees y per day after 3 days onward. So by keeping the book for 7 days means you will pay x plus 7 days means 3 days, fixed charge is x, so x. 7 days means another how many days? 4 days. And per day is how much y? So 4y is equal to rupees 27. Why did Susi pay rupees 21 for keeping the cook 5 days? 5 days means x plus 3 days cancel here. So another 2 days means 2y is equal to rupees 21. So you can solve this easily. It's okay?